going to break through the ice any minute.
Do you think you can stop them?
The best we can do is buy you some time. I'll see you on the other side.
Chamber of Souls. The Divine Source has to be there. Looks like the way into the city center is through that gate.
I have failed. There will be no pardon for my sins. I have drenched my hands in blood in pursuit of the Prophet, and now there is nothing left. As the attack became a siege, the Prophet's people did the unthinkable. They turned their weapons against the glaciers and buried their own city. Mongol and the Prophet's people alike were crushed in the ice. The Khan and his warrior horde are dead. The people of Kitezh are broken and scattered. I alone survive in the frozen heart of the city, and my only companions are the deathless army of the Prophet. Their eyes aflame with unholy light. Even now, they hunt the ruins for survivors.
Stay out of sight. Incredible. The style looks ancient, but it depicts a train, the coming of the Soviets. They tended to the sick here. The survivors must have suffered. A woman's necklace, made of Baltic amber. Incredible craftsmanship. It must have belonged to a noblewoman. Ruins under the water. Demonic possession. They were performing exorcisms.
Deep below the holy ground of our city, we have found the source of the corruption. One of Hell's winding tunnels snakes up and vomits forth a miasma of evil. There is no pattern to the demon's depredations, but his mark is plain. Men driven to wicked words and acts, as God's grace is driven from them. We take them here to the mouth of hell itself to drive out the demons. We do not always succeed. Often the poor wretches are too far gone and they die when we drive the beasts out of them. It is heartbreaking to lose good people, but we must stand against the devil in all his forms.
No telling how many people died here.
My mind is clear today. It was not so yesterday, and it will not be again. They say the devil is inside me. They say I am possessed. I have seen the beast in my heart, and it is only me, only my broken mind. But the priests will not listen. I cannot blame them. Some days they appear to me as apparitions of manifest pain and hatred. So clouded are my eyes. I spit and yowl, for I am mad. But I know there is no evil in my heart, only sickness that no man can cure.
That should be high enough. That looks about right. Let's see if it works. It worked. formula for Greek fire. Iron pendant. Soldiers in the Empire would sometimes tie them to their belts. Blue glass vase. Still in excellent condition. Not many of these survived, for obvious reasons. Vase, made of silver. It's seen a lot of use and travel, but it has a rough portrait of the prophet. They must have begun trading with the outside.
I have made myself a refuge in this frozen hell, in the base of a crumbling tower. I have laid away food and weapons enough to defend myself. But I am the last survivor. By day, I watch the Deathless Army, learn the paths they take. They follow the same patterns, day in and day out, like men trapped in a dream. They are fierce, but they are hollow. Whatever made them men is long gone, replaced instead by a soul of cold iron. I must be careful, but I must know more about them. If this is what the Source can do in the hands of a heretic, think of what it could do in the hands of the righteous.
They're stables. Nothing but bones, picked clean. These are spurs from Mongol horsemen. They're far more decorative and lavish than I'd expect. But they're still well used. Whoever owned them was wealthy, but they rode with the army.
Must have fallen asleep. It is hard to tell time beneath the ice. The Deathless Ones had been busy. Where a pile of ashes smoldered the night before, a corpse now lay, skin as milky white as a dead fish. As I watched, the dead man breathed, a clicking death rattle in reverse, as he sucked air in for the first time in a day. Then he looked at me. And I recognized him at last. I killed this man once before during the battle, and he has not forgotten. So I killed him again, crushed his new skull before he could stand, but his ashes smolder anew. I will not be here when he awakes. The cold look in his eyes was like a promise. Like the phoenix, he will rise again and again. Each time more determined to end my life. If I stay, sooner or later he will succeed. God is testing me. I've scavenged weapons and tools enough to survive. The Khan once demanded I learn to draw a bow and fight like one of his soldiers, and I am grateful for that. He gave me his own arrows, made for punching holes in armor. The ice around me provides all I need to drink, but it runs red with blood. The Prophet's army now patrols a dead city. These are not the soldiers who first met us at the city gates. They've been changed somehow. Among them, I can see a man that I myself killed in the battle. The old legends say that those who looked upon the divine source relinquished their very souls to it, attaining immortality. If this is true, I will surely perish here, buried with the secret I was sent to find.
There's a piece of flint in the pouch. It's a striker to start a fire. Each Mongol soldier had to be self-sufficient. An ancient carving of a pagan god. Perhaps a fertility idol. It's thousands of years old.
At last, I killed one of the deathless soldiers. I tracked him through the day until he was alone. He seemed to sense me before I struck, as if he knew the sound of my bowstring. He was strong, but I am clever and I have faith. My arrows pierced his flesh, but he fought on until I placed a shot between his eyes. Even then, he managed to wound me before I caved in his skull. His body caught fire and fell into ash before my eyes. It has been hours since he died, but his ashes still smolder, hissing and popping in the darkness. I do not believe this is his end. The source has a great and terrible sway over those it touches. I must know what happens next.
Valentinus, the timekeeper.
After the city was built, the first generation of followers stared out upon it. One among them, a man named Valentinus, has spent his whole life devoted to the study of time and its passage. The prophet sought him out in the crowd and asked him what he thought of the city. Valentinus said he felt it was a blessed place, that time would move slowly there, and that Kitezh would last for generations untold. The prophet smiled, for he knew that he had made a home where his people might be safe.
Sure, Mongolian grammar is tricky, but it reads like directions.
Break through that gate. break down that gate. A drinking horn. Not very common in Byzantine culture. This looks like it came from the west, near Kiev. Did it. There's been some structural damage. The battle certainly took its toll, but most of the city is still standing. This mural commemorates the dead lost in the battle, and those that died after of disease and starvation. Thank you.
Souls is through that gate. Just need to find another trebuchet.
Much time, Lara. You must reach the source before them.
There's nothing more you can do. Get somewhere safe.
Not a chance. You need us as much as we need you. We survive together or we die alone. Now go.
Carved wooden relief of what looks like the Prophet of Kitezh. It's well worn and damaged. This isn't made of local timber. Word of the Prophet must have spread. Now to take out that gate.
Almost through. Just one more shot. This should balance the arm. It's not holding water. Got to take them out. Just have to aim this thing.
Oh!
way is clear.